गणानान्त्वा गणपति गुंहवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमम् ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनुश्रुण्वन्नोतिभिस्सीदसादनम् श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशङ्करं लोकशङ्करं सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। द फिफ्थ मंत्र। य इमं मध्वदं वेद आत्मानं जीवमन्तिकात् ईशानं भूतभव्यस्य न ततो विजुगुप्सते एतद्वैतत्। सो वी हैव सीन आत्मानं मत्वा धीरो न शोचति। सो धीर पुरुष, ए करेजियस पर्सन। सो इन फैक्ट द रियल करेज इज इन वेदांत, बिकॉज गोइंग एंड अब्यूजिंग अनदर पर्सन इज नॉट ए करेज, or going and attacking some other person, or the neighbor, a king attacking his neighbor king, these are also called acts of courage. But the real courage is in Vedanta. The real courage is controlling oneself, that is the courage, and the renunciation, that is the courage. So to show your back to the world and look inwards, you need a lot of courage. So such a dhiraha न शोचति आत्मानं मत्वा, हैविंग नोन दट आत्मा ही विल नॉट कम टू ग्रीफ। इन फैक्ट एवरी डे वी प्रे ईश्वर यां मेधां देवगणाः पितरश्च उपासते सो तया मानय मेधया अग्ने मेधा विनं कुरु। लाइक दट वी हैव अ प्रार्थना, बिकॉज धीरा मीन्स धीयं रातीति धीरः, one who has a buddhi which helps him to know the final truth, he is the dhiraha. So he has to protect his buddhi, he has to keep his buddhi subtle, capable of understanding subtle things, that ekagrata, he should be able to maintain it. That's why we pray ishvara agne medhavinam kuru, he agne, please make me, agne means parameshvara, he parameshvara, please make me a dhira purusha, please make me medhavan. And this medha is not only we human beings are seeking medha, devaganaha pitrascha upasate yam medha, this medha is sought by even the devatas, agni indra varuna etc, they seek this medha. Even the pitru devatas, the mains, they also seek this medha, everybody seeks this medha. And so he agne taya manaya medhaya, so that medha you please bring to me, make me medhavi. So like that we pray Ishvara. So by grace of Ishvara, one will get that medha. It is only a matter of time. So one need not be despaired or any such thing, that I have this medha, somebody has, I don't have. There is nothing like that. Every human being has medha. It's only a matter of time that it grows and it becomes mature to know the truth. What is the truth? It is Atma. It is always with yourself only, it is not away from you. If it is paroksham, then maybe it is difficult to know it. But it is your own swarupa. So that atmanam matva dhiraha nashochati. So that atma is further being described. Because it is to be known, so it has to be described further. So Shruti is taking a further description. You see, when you start a mantram, you look at the verb. From the verb onwards, if you proceed, you can easily understand the shlokam. The syntax of the shlokam, it can be easily understood. Tato na vijugupsate. Etadvaitat is okay. That's a separate sentence. So by this knowledge, tataha means because of this knowledge, a person na vijugupsate, he doesn't make an effort to protect himself. Suppose I know that I am safe, Will I make an effort to protect myself? No. Suppose I am insecure, then I will be trying to protect myself. So you see the society. Here it is much better. Whereas I saw in Indian society, the society is insecure. People are here also. People are insecure. So I have food for this dinner or for this lunch, but I am afraid whether I will get the same food tomorrow or not. You see, human existence, all said and done, it boils down to food. You have food and a little shelter, all other things will follow. We can manage with less or more. Basic thing is food and shelter. So, but people are insecure. In spite of having plentiful of food and shelter, they are insecure. That's why, in fact, there was one millionaire. The millionaire, he was insecure. So he met a Mahatma. And he was very insecure. The Mahatma asked him, why you are insecure? I don't know, I am insecure and I am afraid of the future. Then the Mahatma gave him an advice. From today onwards, for 1 week, you cook your own food and eat it. Only thing is, don't cook more than you need. You have to eat what all you cook. You should not throw away food. Food throwing is a bad thing in any case. You cook just enough for your own stomach and eat. Generally, this millionaire means what? Even his wife will not cook, some cook will cook it. So, you cook for yourself. What all you need, you purchase from the market and you cook for yourself and eat. And if you cook more one time, next evening you reduce the amount. You should not cook more. So, that should be the target. So, this man cooked for himself. He did not know how much rice he has to start with. So he put so much rice and cooked. Then he found that it is all excess. Therefore he reduced it to half of it. And now also it is excess. So next day, he is now using just enough rice and just enough vegetables. Like that he cooked for 1 week and he ate. Then the Mahatma asked him, is your insecurity gone? He said, yes, it is gone. Because this millionaire now understands that to live happily, you don't need millions. Just a little rice and one or two vegetables and maybe a little pickle, you are secure. That is all you need really. But people are insecure and they want to protect themselves. Whereas a Mahatma, a Jnani, he never tries to protect himself. Tatona vijugupsate. So that insecurity is gone. Very important thing it is. Insecurity is a very important thing. People will not be able to relax. All psychological problems have a basis in insecurity. You feel secure, you can sleep well. Your stomach, gastric juices will function normally. Heart beats normally. Everything will be all right. You should feel secure. Security will come not by having a 10-foot compound wall with an electric fence and all that. That way you won't get security. That is not security. That is one kind of security, all right. The security agencies are there, but security comes by knowledge. What is the knowledge? I am Atma. I am body, you are never secure. However, insurance, etc., you may do, you are never secure. In the identification of body, there is no security. Only in the understanding of Atma, there is security. Tatona vijugupsate. Such a person, he never bothers. He is never bothered by this sense of insecurity. Who is that? Yaha Veda. Who knows? Yaha Veda means who knows. Knows what? Atmanam. What else? Yaha Atmanam Veda. Which Atma? Imam Atmanam Veda. I am Atma Brahma. Imam Atmanam. I am Atma. Converted into Dvitiya Vibhakti. Imam Atmanam. So, this Atma, that means Hrudaye Nihitam, Guhayam Nivishtam. So, in this Buddhi Guha, it is there. This Atma is known. So, whosoever knows this Atma, Imam Atmanam Veda. Imam also means the way it is described earlier, in the earlier mantras, that Atmanam. What kind of Atma? Madhvadam Veda. Madhu Adam. Atma, the etymology of the Atma, I remind you, Atiti Atma, Adabhakshana. So, Ada is the Dhatu, Ati iti Atma. Bhokta, you see, Atma is described as Karta as well as Bhokta. You see, Jiva is a Karta and Bhokta, you know. Atma, Shuddha, Chaitanyam is neither Karta nor Bhokta. That is the final theory. But generally, you assume yourself to be Karta and Bhokta, right? Now, I tell you, you become Karta by identification or by highlighting your identification with the body, mind, sense complex. And you become Bhokta by highlighting the consciousness aspect of yours. You highlight the physical body, your physical body is also you. Your physical body is you only. Your physical body is not outside you. Nothing is outside Atma. Then Buddhi is also you. And Atma Chaitanyam is you. So, you know in which platform you stand. You stand in the platform of the body and then say, I am the Karta. Karta means doer. Doer means what? Karta, from morning to evening I have worked. Means what? You are identifying yourself with the body to say that. So, Karta. In Karta, the physical aspect, namely the insentient body aspect, is highlighted. And by highlighting that, Atma becomes Karta. But instead of highlighting that, you highlight the Chaitanyam. Atma becomes Bhokta by identification with the Upadhi. So, Atmendriya Manoyuktam Bhokte Chahur Manishinaha. That vachyam you should remember. Purushas Prakrutistho Hibhunte Prakruti Jan Gunan Karanam Gunasangosya Sadasadyoni Janmasu. That in chapter Gita. Therefore, you identify yourself with the Prakruti. Prakruti starts with the physical body. Also, it extends up to Buddhi. And Ahankara, that is also Prakruti. Mahabhutanya Ahankaraha, that is how Bhagavan described Kshetram. So that ego sense, which is a part of the Buddhi, that is also a Kshetram, which is Prakruti really. So when you identify yourself with the body level, you are the Karta. You identify with the Buddhi and Ahankara level, you are the Bhokta. Karma phala Bhokta. Bhokta is not body. Tongue is not the Bhokta. It appears as though tongue is the Bhokta. Tongue is not the Bhokta. You, the Purusha, is the Chetana Purusha is the Bhokta. So tongue only becomes an instrument in the... Tongue is like that spoon. You know, while cooking, you use a spoon-like thing to mix it, you know. While cooking, during the cooking, you have to mix it a little. So for mixing, you use a spoon. That spoon, is it tasting that food or what? No? It is not tasting the food. So this tongue is like that. The taster is Atma. Bhokta is different. Tongue is only like a spoon only. You take a spoon and put in the tongue. The spoon is doing one job. Tongue is doing a similar job. It's an instrument. Indriyam means what? Karanam. Indriyam has got another name, Karanam. Karanam means instrument. So, tongue is an instrument to know the taste, rasam. Who is the one that knows? Not tongue. Through tongue, the bhokta knows. And that bhokta, what is the essential swarupam of the bhokta? When you say bhokta, you are talking of the Chaitanya. Because in Bhokta, the highlight is that of Chaitanya. Therefore, Madhvadam, Madhu means Karma Phala. Karma Phala, Madhu is a Karma Phala. Any result that comes to you is Karma Phala. In fact, everything is Karma Phala. Everything. You are breathing fresh air, that is Karma Phala. Suddenly, some exhaust of the other car or whatever has come, and therefore now you breathe some dirty air and feel unhappy about it, and comply. That is also Karma Phala. Again, run away from there and now breathe fresh air. Again, Karma Phala. Everything is Karma Phala. Therefore, Madhu Adam. So, Atma, in its identification, or joining, adjunct means Upadhi, you know. So, in its being, in the presence of the adjunct, the body, mind, sense complex, it is the Bhokta. Therefore, you don't identify yourself with the body, mind, sense complex and say, this is Bhokta, this is not the Bhokta. The Bhokta is Atma, yena rupam rasam gandham sparshaanscha maithunan vijanati. So he is that the person who knows is the bhokta. The knower is the bhokta. Nobody else. Therefore, that Atma Chaitanya is in the presence of agent becoming the bhokta. Madhvadam. Jivam. That is another adjective. Jivam Atmanam Veda. Atma is a jiva. What an adjective it is? Jivam. You see, jiva means jiva pranadharana. Jivati jivataha jivanti. That is the root, dhatu. So, jivam means, Bhashyakara says, pranadi kalapasya dharayitaram. You see, dharayita means sustainer. Atma chaitanyam is obtaining in this body. And that Atma Chaitanyam is the one which sustains the life forces of this body. Jivam is that. What are the life forces? The blood in the veins is circulating. The heart is pumping. What a mechanism it is. It goes on pumping. It doesn't ask for any rest and all that. Suppose it is asks, it applies for rest, we are in hospital. Nowhere else. So that is it. That is how the heart functions continuously. And then every cell functions, they don't know rest. And the breathing, the lungs, they will be taking in oxygen and throwing out carbon dioxide. They will be doing it all the time. So much of when you are asleep or when you are awake, so much of intense activity is going on. That is what is called jiva. And that jiva, which mainly consists of kriya shakti. Jiva is the highlight of kriya shakti. You know, madhvadam is the highlighting of vijnana shakti. Atma is having two shaktis. So one shakti is vijnana shakti, that is madhvadam. Another shakti is kriya shakti, that is jiva. Jiva pranadharana. Therefore, in the form of prana, panam, jnana, udana, and samana, all these prana functions, metabolic functions, in the form of those functions, the Atma Chaitanyam is sustaining this body, jivam. And this Atma, I want to know, all right, somebody has to know, but is it near to you or is it far away? Antikat. It is very close to you. Closest to you. How close? There cannot be anything closer than that. It is closest because it happens to be your own Swarupa. Whenever you say Aham, in that Aham, Atma is there. In fact, Aham has got a false status and a reality. Wave has got a false status and a reality. What is the false status of wave? Wavelength and amplitude. That is the false status of wave. What is the reality? Water. So Aham. So the limited being is false. But being is Atma. It is a being, all right. It is a limited conscious being. Is it okay? That is what is called Aham. What is Aham? A limited conscious being. In that, Ye is false. Ye is what? Ye means one. One among many. It is false. And the division is false. Bheda is false. And limited is false. Conscious being is the reality. So that is Atma. Antike. Then another very interesting. An adjective to Atma. Ishanam. Ishanam means ishte iti ishaha iti eat or ishaha. Means one who is in charge of. That is the Ishanam. So here Atma becomes Ishanam how? Bhuta Bhavyasya. Bhuta is past tense. Bhavya is future tense. In fact, I tell you, in Vedanta, we recognize only Bhuta and Bhavishyat. We don't recognize present. And not only that, by the time you recognize the present, there is no Kala. Kala is gone and you end up in Atma. You see, Bhutam and Bhavya you take. Today is there. Today is it Bhuta or Bhavya? Bhavya is future. Bhuta is past. Okay, today is it Bhuta or Bhavya or present? Today up to this moment, up to 7:40, it is Bhuta. And whatever is about to come, it is Bhavya. What is the present? There is no present at all. No, 7:40 is the present. That minute, in that 12 seconds have gone. So 12 seconds is Bhuta.
48 seconds is bhavya. So which is the present then?
No, no, this 12th minute is the present. No, no, in that 12th minute, in the 12th second is the present. In the 12th second, there are 1000 milliseconds, of which 330 milliseconds is the past, and 670 milliseconds is the future.
No, no, that millisecond is the present. In that millisecond, there are 1000 microseconds. Part of it is past. So there is no present. There is no present. Then what is present? Present is presence. That is Atma. There is no present other than Atma Chaitanya. Present is presence. You say present, keeping the eyes open. Then what happens? It appears as though there is something called present. But you close the eyes and tell, is present different from presence? Present is presence, and presence is you. Atma. Atma Chaitanyam it is. So this present, present tense, which is none other than presence, and therefore which is the Atma, this is the controller of the past and future. Because a person is crying. Mahatma asks him, why you are crying? No, somebody, my beloved is disappeared, that's why I am crying. When the beloved has disappeared? 1 year back. That means he is crying in the present for the past. Therefore now that past, is it in the present or is it in the past? It is in the present only. You see, past is gone. The past, the person drags it and brings it into the present. Therefore when he is crying about a past event, in fact he made the past into present. He is worried about the future. He made the future, he brought the future, he dragged the future into the present. In fact, it is the present which controls the past and the future. It is the, not controls, which contains. Where is the past? They say past, where is it? In the present. They say future, where it is? It is in the present. The past has to be re-experienced only when it becomes present. You have to remember it now, and the present, the future, you will have a concern about the future only when you bring it into the present. Therefore, the future and past are in the present, and the present is in the presence, which is Atma. And therefore, we can say, Atma is Bhuta Bhavyasya Ishanam. It is the one which controls the past and the future. In fact, there is no past, there is no future, there is only present. The present only is there. There is nothing like a past or future. It is all notions. It is even the time is notion. Time is nothing but notion. And therefore, outside Atma, there is no past, there is no present, there is no future. All tenses are imagination, or all superimposition on Atma Chaitanya. Therefore, it is the Atma which sustains kala, time. Therefore, Ishanam, Ishanam, Bhuta Bhavyasya, Na Tato Vijugupsite. So that kind of Atma, a person who knows that Atma, such person, Na Vijugupsite. He says, Bhashyakara says, Na Gopayitum Icchati. He is not concerned about security. He doesn't want to protect himself. Because he doesn't need protection. Why? Abhaya Praptatvat. That is what Bhashyakara says. He is Abhayam. He is in Abhayam. Abhayam, you know, abhayam means a sense of security. There is no fear. What a statement it is. Abhayam, you see, atmajnanam and abhayam, they go together really. And there is, in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, there is one samvada between Yajnavalkya Maharshi and Janaka Maharaja. And after teaching is over, then the teacher, the Maharshi says, abhayam vai janaka praptosi. Hey Janaka, you have gained abhayam. In fact, what Janaka gained is Atmajnanam. So the Atmajnanam, the gain of Atmajnanam is equated to the gain of abhayam. There is no fear. That's why I told you earlier the example of the king saying to a jnani, I will kill you. The jnani laughed in his face. He laughed at him. You are going to kill me? Come on, you cannot kill me. You can kill the body, but I am not the body. Now it is the king's turn to be surprised.
what a person he is. Therefore, for a jnani, there is no bhayam. Because he gained that atma, which is abhayasthanam. You know, bhayam comes from dvaitam. Dvaitam means the division. So you look, you see things different. See different people, different things, different, everything is plural. There is bhayam to you. It is one against many. But if everything is atma, then ko mohah ka shokah ekatvam anupashyatah. That atmaivedam sarvam ekamaiva advitiyam brahma aham atma, ayam atma brahma aham brahmasmi. In that knowledge there is the bhayam, there is no bhayam. Bhashyakara says, as long as a person is in the midst of fear and he considers himself as a mortal going to die, as long as a person considers himself like that, so then he tries to safeguard himself. He tries for security, but not a jnani. In fact, one Mahatma told, you don't bother about health of the body. Body is not you. You don't become a prisoner of the body either. You are the divinity. You are the Atma Chaitanyam. You are the infinite. You recognize that truth, then health will follow you. You will be healthy only. There cannot be a better treatment for our problems of body and mind than the Atma Jnana. An Atma Jnani rarely becomes illness. The illness, it really doesn't hinder him. Illness also is a part of the Prakruti. Prakruti means so many changes are coming. The trees have lost all their wardrobe. They are bare. So, the other day nature was having a beautiful attire. Now it has got a different attire. All the leaves have gone. New leaves will come. This is how the Prakruti is like that. So, body is also like a tree only. What is the greatness of this body? It is also like any other tree, any other animal, any other creature. For a small creature, its body is as precious to it as your body to you. So, people put so much investment on their own body. They don't care for other people's bodies or other creatures' bodies. Their own body is all important. It is that kind of a sense of insecurity is a product of lack of proper understanding of Atma. Therefore, there is no abhayam greater than Atma-jnana. Tato navijyu gupsate. Bhashyakara says, Atma is nityam, eternal, and advaitam, it is non-dual. One who knows this truth, he is afraid of what? What is the source of his fear? So, tada kim kah kutova gopayitam ichet? Who is going to protect? Of what? From what? So, there is no fear. And that abhayasthanam, abhayasthanam means that repository of fearlessness, of security, that is atma. Etad vaitat. Next mantra. Yah purvam tapaso jatam adhyah purvamajayata guham pravishya tishthantam yo bhute bhirvyapashyata etad vaitat. You see, in the earlier mantra, Brahma is presented as Pratyagatma. Pratyagatma means the innermost consciousness. That is how it is presented. How? Madhvadam. Madhvadam is what? Bhokta means the innermost consciousness it is. And also Jivam. Antikat means is innermost. Here, the same Brahma or Atma is being presented in this mantra as Sarvatma. It is not only the innermost Atma consciousness here, it is Sarvatma, the Atma of every living cell in this universe. Not being a cell, Even in the body of a creature there are many cells. And every cell has got an Atma. So Chaitanya, which is Atma. And that Atma is non-dual, it is one. This is what is called Sarvatma Bhava. In fact, Jivan Mukti means liberation from samsara while living. That is Jivan Mukti. Is none other than Sarvatma Bhava. That Sarvatma Bhava is being described in this mantra. You see, the thesis or the proposition is like this, how in this universe, you can understand the entire universe by understanding yourself. So in this universe, the cosmos, or the microcosm, namely you as a being, as a limited being, as a jiva, there are only two things, not three. You bring in third and become a person in bondage. That third you bring in. What are the two? Prakruti and Purusha. For example, you take your own case. In your own case, what is there in you? What is all there within you? You just look at yourself objectively. A body, mind, sense complex is there. That is Prakruti. Up to mind which includes mano buddhya hankara chittani, all the four put together is one mind stuff. So body, senses, body, physical body, the senses and the mind stuff, all that is Prakruti. Mahabhutanya hankara, Bhagavan's description of Prakruti, Kshetram. So Kshetram is Prakruti. So that is one. Second is consciousness, Chaitanyam. That is one. That is all. Or, once I told you in this universe, there are three things. One is Dravyam and Kriya and Shakti. If you count that way, then there are only three, fourth is not there. That you have to say. So if you count two, Prakruti and Purusha, only two. Third is not there. What I mean when I say third is not there? Third means, I, the limited being, the jiva, he doesn't exist. What is this jiva? Where from he has come? Is he Prakruti or is he Purusha? If he is Purusha, then he is infinite. Brahma he is. If he is Prakruti, then he is jada, he is insentient. Do you agree to that? Therefore, what is this jiva? Jiva is a granthi. This granthi we will discuss in Mundaka. We are coming to it sooner. Tomorrow evening itself we will start this granthi, will come in this week. Therefore this jiva is a knot between the Prakruti and Purusha. So Bhashyakara says, Satyanruta Mithuni Karanam, he says. It is a, you mix up two things. Mix up is not. So the Prakruti and Purusha, the mix up is jiva. In fact, in jiva there are two parts. The knot, the combination, the clubbing is jiva. You remove the Prakruti part and merge it in Prakruti. What left is a consciousness, Chaitanyam part. And that Chaitanyam is common to the entire universe. Therefore, there is no jiva. An individual jiva is a figment of imagination. He is the product of ignorance. There is no individual, really. What you are thinking as individual is not different from the whole. You are, because you are afraid of the whole, becoming one with the whole. So you want to maintain your individuality. So your limitedness you want to maintain. That is your ignorance, that's all. You are never different from the whole. So that is what is presented here. Yah purvam tapaso jatam adhyah purvam ajayata guham pravishya tishthantam. So, you know that Hiranyagarbha, who is the Samashti, who is the whole. Here we are talking of Hiranyagarbha. He is the Sarvatma. So, he is your body, everybody's body is in Hiranyagarbha. Everybody's Indriyas are in Hiranyagarbha. Everybody's Buddhi is in Hiranyagarbha. Your Buddhi is not your individual Buddhi. It is a part of Hiranyagarbha. And your Kriya Shakti is or Prana Shakti. So that is also part of Hiranyagarbha. So we will see all that. This mantra, next mantra is all about Hiranyagarbha and also Sarvatma Bhava. Very interesting it is. So, this Hiranyagarbha is presented in a sequence of creation. Many a time I mentioned it. So, there is Param Brahma, Nirguna Param Brahma. Now, this Nirguna Param Brahma becomes the cause of the universe. How? Not as Nirguna Param Brahma alone. So, in the Nirguna Param Brahma, to explain the creation of this universe, we posit in that Nirguna Param Brahma a Maya, a Maya Shakti. He created this universe? Yes. He or it, whatever it is, created this universe? Yes. Then there must be a faculty or a Shakti or power of creation in him, in it? Yes, it is there. That is what is Maya, not a big deal, really. Therefore, it is like wave is there. Where from this wave has come? From water. That means in the water, there must be a character. It is called fluidity. Water is a fluid. Waves are there only in fluids. Waves are not there in solids. The solids won't give you waves. This kind of waves it won't. They will give sound waves, which are different waves. So this kind of waves, they are formed only in fluids. Fluids means what? Liquids and gases. That's all. They are called fluids. So water is a fluid. Therefore, it can give rise to waves, right? This floor cannot give rise to waves. If you hit it, it will break or it remains what it is. It won't give rise to a wave. Whereas you hit water, it gives rise to a wave. A disturbance gives rise to a wave. What is the difference between this and the water? Water can give rise to waves. Can. C-A-N. Can. What is this can? Can means a capacity, a power. So water has got the power to give rise to waves. What is that power? It's a fluid. That is the power. Fluidity is the power. And so now we say water has the power called fluidity that can give rise to waves. So that is a Shakti. Now this fluidity, is it different from water? It is sticking to the water or what? Fluidity, is something sticking to the water? No, it is water. Then if it is water, why you are talking about it like that separately? You have to explain waves, that's why we are talking about it separately. Similarly, this entire universe has come out of Brahma. Then that Brahma must have a creative faculty. Yes, indeed, he has got a creative faculty. We call it as a Srujana Shakti. So, the power to create, and the name for it is Maya. So, now we have split the Brahma. We have split water. How? Water with fluidity. That is the splitting. Splitting means what? What kind of a splitting it is? Just to explain an effect, you bring in a cause, a status of being a cause. Similarly, the Nirguna Param Brahma is a split. As though you are not really split, you are not really splitting water. So, Nirguna Param Brahma has got the creative faculty. What is that? Maya. So now, don't say any more Nirguna Param Brahma. Because you have brought in Maya, now you can say Nirguna Param Brahma. It is an attribute to Param Brahma. That's why we change the name. The name is Ishvara. Because Maya Vachchanna Chaitanyam Ishvaraha. Okay. Now, this Maya becomes Mahatatmam. You talk of Maya alone, then Maya gives birth to Mahatattva. You don't talk of Maya alone. Maya with Chaitanyam you talk. That means Ishvara, Maya with Chaitanyam is Ishvara. Ishvara gives birth to Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha is Mahatattva with Chaitanyam. If you highlight the Maya aspect, Prakriti aspect, it is called Maya. It is called Mahat. If you highlight the Chaitanyam aspect, it is called Ishvara. Maya Vachchana Chaitanyam Ishvaraha. And this Mahatattva Avachchana Chaitanyam Hiranyagarbhaha. That is how it is understood. Therefore, that Hiranyagarbha has come from Ishvara. How? Purvam Tapaso Jatam. Ishvara has got Maya Shakti. That Maya Shakti is the cause for a desire to create. So Maya Shakti expresses itself as a desire to create. Maya Shakti can be a desire also. Ichha Shakti, Kriya Shakti, Jnana Shakti, all these are Shakti manifestations. So that desire to create that is there from that desire, so that Chaitanyam has manifested as Hiranyagarbha Purvam at the time of creation. That is the first step in that creation. And this Hiranyagarbha, from that Hiranyagarbha came Panchabhutas, the five elements, Prithivi, Yuktejo, Vayu, Akasha, in a sequence. Therefore, Ishvara or Brahma is earlier to Hiranyagarbha in a sequence, and this Hiranyagarbha himself is earlier to the five elements. So, Adhya Purvam Ajayata, Adhyaha means waters. So, earlier to waters. Why waters alone? Why not all the five? Yes, indeed, the word waters stands for all the five. So that is the sequence. Now, in this sequence, how many things you are getting? Two things. Prakruti Purusha. Over. Now, bring down that sequence further down. So finally, you ended up with a human being. And now in this human being, what are there? Whatever is there in the creation beginning, they are only there. So, Prakruti. What is this Prakruti? A physical body, senses and buddhi. That is Prakruti. And in that Chaitanyam, it is there. That is Brahma. Guham pravishyatishthantam. So, started with Hiranyagarbha, Ishvara, Hiranyagarbha. That Hiranyagarbha, who is the universal soul, has expressed himself as infinite souls. It is, you are the child of Hiranyagarbha, I am the child of Hiranyagarbha. A bird, an animal, a creature, an ant, a bug, everything is a child of Hiranyagarbha really. Therefore, that Hiranyagarbha has expressed himself in the form of all these living beings. And how he has expressed? In Hiranyagarbha, there are two principles, two tattvas. Tattva is a principle. What are they? One is the Mahatattvam with the Chaitanyam. That is Hiranyagarbha. That Chaitanyam is there in every one of these living beings. And that Mahatattvam is also there. Mahatattvam gives rise to Panchabhutas, and therefore the physical body, and senses and mind, all these complexes. So that that Upadhi, we call it the Ajant. So physical body, mind, sense, complex. That complex is called agent. So that agent is the expression of the Mahatattva. So in this situation, where from aham came? I? Where from I came? Did you find any place for this I? Only two things are there. So, just I summarize, Brahma. In Brahma, you have a Shakti, not different from Brahma. Like Agni has Shakti, Dahaka Shakti, burning power, not different from Agni. So that Shakti and the Brahma is Chaitanyam. Come one step down. Mahatattvam, Chaitanyam. Shakti plus Chaitanyam is Ishvara. Mahatattvam plus Chaitanyam is Hiranyagarbha. Come further down and down. You have every living being. So in every living being, how many things are there? Two. What are they? Guham pravishyatishthantam. The guha is the prakruti, buddhi, and also yo bhutebhirvya pasyata. This buddhi is not only buddhi is the expression of prakruti, the indriyas are also expression of prakruti. Vya pasyata, it sees. So the indriyam, the sense organ which sees, what is it? I. That is also prakruti. And then the anatomy of that I, Panchabhutas, that is also Prakruti. Ya bhutebhihi vyapasyata. Bhutebhihi means bhutaihi, together with the Panchabhutas. So now what you have? Guham ya bhutebhir vyapasyata. That is all the Prakruti manifestation. And in that guha, in that buddhi guha, the cave of the heart, buddhi guha, means buddhi chartha. That is the meaning of it is buddhi. So it is a secret not easily known, that's why we use the word guha. There, in that guha, what is there? Ishvara Chaitanya. Therefore, look at yourself this way. How? this body is a part of the Hiranyagarbha. This Chaitanyam is that Brahma. Suppose a cell of the hand, a cell in your hand, it says, I have nothing to do with the body. What a silly thing to say. Suppose the liver says, I am not part of this body. Then do you accept that situation? Is it logical? No. Similarly, you cannot say you are an individual. You are part of the whole. So, forget about this Vyashti Bhavana. It makes you insecure. You are not Vyashti. You are, suppose 10 people are there. I remain isolated. I am not ready to mix with those 10 people. Am I secure? No. Suppose I am one with all the 10 people. I feel one with every one of them. I go and sit in their midst. Then what? Then I am secure. I am happy and unhappy together with them. That is how the psychology works really. Similarly, just I gave you a small example, but the truth is, your prakruti amsham, the prakruti aspect in you as a person, is one with the prakruti, that my macrocosm prakruti, and the chaitanyam, that is another aspect of you as a person, it is one with Brahma. Guham pravishyatishthantam yo bhute bhirvyapashyata. Therefore, that atma, which was the pratyagatma, the innermost consciousness, it is the same consciousness which is there in Ishvara, which is there in Hiranyagarbha. All the limitations are superimposition. They are imputed to that Chaitanyam by you because of your fear and your greed. There is fear, therefore you assume that Atma is limited. You have greed, therefore you assume that Atma is one among many. Except for fear and greed, there is no difference at all. There is no limitedness also. That's why in deep sleep, there is no fear, there is no greed, there is no division, and only one Atma Chaitanyam is there. And that's why you enjoy sleep so much, really. That is the reason why sleep is such an enjoyable thing. So, etadvai tat Vashyakara says, ya evam pashyati, sa etadeva pashyati, yatta prakrutam brahma. Who knows this truth, who recognizes this truth, is already understanding what is Brahma. He has known Brahma really. What a relief it is. Now the individual is falsified. Once the individual is falsified, from that position, you can allow the life, the prarabdha to unfold, and whatever things have to be done, whatever is your duty, you can do that without a sense of kartrutva. And so there is no punyam, there is no papam, there is only one Atma and one Brahma. Next. या प्राणेन संभवति अदितिर्देवतामयी गुहां प्रविश्यतिष्ठन्तीं या भूतेभिर्व्यजायत एतद्वैतत्. Vashyakara said, it is just the same as earlier mantra. Absolutely no difference. Only words are different. Then what for this mantra is there? This mantra is a reflection of that Vedic culture. In Veda, you know how it has come. You see, Brahma is there. That Brahma is Advayam, non-dual. Any number of times we have to mull upon this really. So that Brahma is non-dual. But then Brahma is the cause of this universe. So being non-dual absolutely, how he can be the cause of the universe? So the moment you say Brahma Jagat Karanam, then he must have the creative faculty. I am going through once again the same story, nothing new, because mantra is same again. So Brahma Jagat Ka, he is having the Srujana Shakti. Now this from that Srujana Shakti, I used the words earlier, Maya, Mahatattva, etc., right? Now I will not use those words. I will use the word Shakti only. This Shakti is a Strilinga Shabdam. Therefore, I say, I now personify the Shakti for the purpose of worshipping. That is Devi Upasana. This is the origin of Devi Upasana. You know Devi Upasana? Devi Upasana means worship of the mother goddess. That is Devi Upasana. The other day you have worshipped Lakshmi. Lakshmi you have worshipped. What is Lakshmi? The goddess of wealth. Why should be goddess of wealth? Why not god of wealth? God is Pumlinga, you know, masculine. And goddess is feminine. Why this should be goddess of wealth? You know, probably I think in Western theology it is all god of wealth only. Even the god of desires, Cupid, even he is a male. Male shamanism is more in Western theology, I should say that. Whereas here, in Hindu culture, male shamanism is not there in the culture, it is there in the society. Because the society has distanced itself from the culture. That's why in the entire Shastram there is no untouchability. But in the society, there was untouchability. There is no untouchability now in the Hindu society. There was untouchability. In the entire Shastram it is not there. Where from it has come? I say this is what is called Kali Yuga. In the entire Shastram, women were treated with very high regard. But in the society, women are looked down. Society is different, Shastram is different. That is the downfall of a society. Society becomes, Shastram is different and society is different means what? That is the downfall. So the more you are near to this Shastram, the higher you travel. Like you make a constitution and you follow it only in breach, never follow it in following, then what kind of a constitution it is? So it is like that. In India they made a constitution. They changed it by 100 times till now. I say, come on, throw that constitution into the Bay of Bengal and make a fresh constitution. Because, you see, it is like one person was having a shirt. This shirt, if there is a small patch, you can make a patch work and use it. But there are only patches, there is no shirt. Original shirt is gone long back. Only patches are left. What for it is? You throw it and you have another shirt. So Indian constitution is like that. Presently only patches are there. It is 250 pages, original constitution. 100 amendments. Each amendment 5 pages. Now which is a, so why Shakti is example is exactly coinciding there. So you throw the, they are saying that now. You throw it and make a new constitution. Anyway, so that means what? They made a constitution, they never stuck to it. They moved away from it. Anyway, the point is, let us come back to the point. You personify that principle. You get a goddess or god. This is the how the devata comes into the picture. They say Hindus worship many gods. Silly. Hindus are not worshipping many gods. Hindus are worshipping one god. He is not even god really. In the sense it is understood. Hindus worship one Ishwar. This fact, many Hindus also don't know this. I assure you. So, Hindus worship one Ishvara in many aspects. In many aspects. Suppose a student worships Ishvara. In which form he worships Ishvara? Ishvara who gives knowledge, Saraswati. A businessman worships Ishvara. An Ishvara who gives wealth, Lakshmi. A farmer who is looking for rains, he worships Ishvara. In the form of the rain god. He is called rain god. There is no separate rain god. It is only one god. When you worship for the sake of rain, he becomes rain god. So, this Shakti is a Sanskrit word and it is Strilingam. And so, when you look at Ishvara in the form of that Shakti, then Ishvara becomes a goddess rather than god. Because it is a Strilingam. Laksha Sampat. Sampat means wealth, that is the Strilinga Shabda it is. Dakaranta Strilinga Sampat Shabda. Therefore, the goddess it becomes, not god. So, like that it goes. The rain god is a male. Do you know why? In Sanskrit, rain is called Parjanyaha. Parjanyaha or Meghaha. That is the rain or clouds. That is Pumlinga. Pumlinga Shabda. Therefore, the rain god is male. That is the only difference. That is the only point there. So anyway, so that Shakti is goddess. And she, that goddess, Maya Shakti, what is the next stage of that goddess? Buddha Mahatattvam, you know. Mahatattvam means Buddhi, I tell you. Buddhi, Mahat means Buddhi. Your Buddhi is a Chota Buddhi, small Buddhi. But your Buddhi is a part of the universal Buddhi. That universal Buddhi means the Buddhi of the Hiranyagarbha. Buddhi of Hiranyagarbha. How much Buddhi it is? Very big Buddhi it is, because it is the Buddhi of the Hiranyagarbha. He knows every one of you. And also he is having every one of your emotions as part of his Buddhi. So his Buddhi is really big Buddhi. That's why it is called Mahat. So now that Buddhi, Mahatattvam is Buddhi. If you say Mahat, it is Napumsakalingam. Mahatattvam also Napumsakalingam. But replace the word Mahatattvam with Buddhi, which it is really, it is Srilinga. Therefore, another Devata. And her name is, now you have to say her. Her name is Adithihi. Her name is Adithihi. And Adithi is married to a person called Kashyapa. Who is this Kashyapa? Buddhi is married to whom? Buddhi is married to a Jnani, right? They make a good combination. Kashyapa is a Jnani. How? Kashyapa Pashyako Bhavati. He is Pashyakaha. Pashyakaha Pashyati iti Pashyakaha. He sees. Yat sarvam paripashyati iti saukshmyat. In Vedam it is all there. So he sees everything. Sarvam paripashyati. Pari means not only just superficial pashyati. Pashyati means sees. Paripashyati. He really looks at it. With an incisive eye he looks at it. Saukshmyat. The subtle aspect of the truth also he looks at it. Therefore he is called Pashyakaha. Pashyaka reverse what you will get Kashyapa. So a Pashyaka has got Buddhi, very good Buddhi. So Kashyapa Maharshi, the sage Kashyapa, married Aditi. This Aditi, suppose Kashyapa, a Jnani and Buddhi they marry, what will come out of it? Brilliance will come out of it. So the Lord of Sun is the child of that Kashyapa and Aditi. Because he is brilliance itself. So like that, the sun god is supposed to be the child of that Aditi. And that Aditi is in you. How? Buddhi is in you. That is Aditi. And this Aditi, Devatamayi. She is having all devatas in her. Even according to the story of the Puranas, the Kashyapa Maharshi married Aditi. And they got children. And all these devatas are their children only. Aditi and Kashyapa's children are the devatas. Surya, Indra, Varuna, all these are children of Aditi and Kashyapa. This is a Purana story. Everybody knows this story. Everybody means who knows Puranas, they know this story. They know only story. The meaning behind it, they don't know. This is the meaning behind it. So Aditir Devata Mayi. Aditi is full of devatas. In fact, she is not Devata Mayi. She is a Devata Mayi. Mayi means what? Mother, you know. So she is the mother of all devatas. So in you also there is Aditi. And this Aditi who is in you, she is also Devata Mayi. Because each indriyam, each sense organ is a devata. I is a devata. I is a devata means why it is a devata? Dhyotana Shelatvat. It illuminates. So I illuminates this part. A part is a part because I looks at it and recognizes it. I illuminates the part. Every object of this world, Nama and Rupa. Rupa is illuminated by the eye. And Nama is illuminated by the ear. So ear is a devata. I is a devata. All these devatas are centered where? In Buddhi. The information gathered by I goes where? Into the Buddhi. Gathered by the ear, again into the Buddhi. Therefore, Buddhi is the mother. I is the child. Aditir Devatamayi. And so, this Buddhi is the Guha. This I is the one medium where the buddhi is functioning. So into that buddhi, who is Aditi, Ishvara has entered. How he has entered? In the form of Chaitanyam. Guham pravishyatishthantim ya bhute bhirvyajayata. Same concept. Only thing is, just the highlighting is slightly different. So in the form of goddess, instead of talking in terms of tattvas or principles and using the neuter gender words, we have used Strilinga Shabdas and made it a right situation for Devi Upasana, really. The entire Devi Upasana has originated from this concept. But unfortunately, they are separated from this concept. You see, everything is a devata. Everything. Nothing is other than outside devata. That's why everything is Aditi only. Because Aditi hi devatamayi. That's why we have a mantra. Aditir dyaur aditir antariksham. Aditir matasa pitasa cha putraha. This is one mantra. In another mantra, prano mata, prana pita, prana putraha. That is another mantra. This is in Chandogya. This concept, you see, there is a wife and husband and they have a child, one son. Now, this husband, we say he is the husband. All right. But the husband, is he not the pranam? Prana means, you know, life. Who is this husband? Is he not life? Yeah, he is life. Okay. Then wife. Who is this wife? Again life. Life only. And then putraha, son. Who is the son? Life. My God. Pranapita. Pranaha mata. Pranaputraha. It is one universal life in which you have just by the adjunct, the upadhi, you have put names. And you have... What is this husband? Husband is a very special entity or what? A very special animal or what? Husband is what? Husband is a life living in a body. He has eyes through which he sees. He has a buddhi through which he thinks. And ears has got, he hears, hands will hold. That is the husband. Then what is wife? Exactly the same. And what is the son? Exactly the same. Then can we say that it is all one prana only? Yes, indeed it is so. This is what is called Sarvatma. This is how Veda teaches. Vedic teaching is very unique, I tell you. So, that way here also, Adithi, that Aditi Devata, who is the Buddhi Shakti, she is Dyauh, Dyuloka, Antariksham. She is Antariksha Devata. Mata, Mata is Buddhi and also Indriyas is Mata. Mata is what? Some Buddhi and some Indriyas. Therefore, she is Aditi. Pita, again same, Aditi. Putraha, Aditi. Everything is Aditi. And into that Aditi, that Chaitanyam is there. Kriya Shakti, Buddhi, Ichcha Shakti, Jnana Shakti, that is Aditi. Atma Chaitanyam, that is Parameshwara. That is all what you are. There is nothing more than that. Therefore, as you are a part and parcel of that Aditi, and the Atma Chaitanyam is Parabrahma. So, you resolve this Vyashti. Vyashti means individual, into that Ishvara. Individual is a product of fear and greed. You please remember, I tell you. Individual is a product of fear and greed. Otherwise, there is no individual. There is only one prana shakti. There is only one aditi. There is only one set of panchabhutas. There is only one chaitanyam. Everything is one. So, one prakruti, one purusha. Both resolved in advaya param brahma. Etad vaitat, that advaya param brahma, is, hey Nachiketa, what you are asking about, and I was teaching you about that only. We'll continue. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Tat Sat Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.